little over 30 years ago, this was an all-steam country. Steam blended into the landscape and was an everyday sight. The variety of working was considerable, from the industrial lowlands around Edinburgh and Glasgow, to the remote western highlands and the lines to Fort William and Malaig. Until the early 1960s, the remote single-track line to the port of Malaig was steam-operated. These scenes were taken in 1952. At this stage, K2s with the K4s dominated this lonely outpost of steam operation. The K2s were a Great Northern design, but were associated for many years after grouping with the West Highland Line. This engine is in LNER green, with British Railways lettering on the tender. This green livery was applied to 17 of the class after the Second World War. It was to last a short time, with the last engine repainted black in 1953. All the K2s in the Scottish area were fitted with side window cabs in the 30s, and in 1934, all the regular West Highland engines were given the names of lochs. Here, steam connected with a ferry running across to the southern tip of the Isle of Skye. The Isle of Skye was, and still is, served by another ferry running the short distance from Cail of Lough Alsh to Cailleachan. When this scene was taken in 1952, traffic on both ferries was comparatively light. The following years were to see great change to the lines serving the Western Isles. Dieselisation was completed by 1963, and threads of closure to both the Malaig and Kyle lines came and went in the 1960s and 70s. Then, in the mid-1980s, with the tourist potential of this area fully realised, steam returned on a regular basis. Green LNER moguls have returned to the line in the shape of K1 number 2005. addition to the K1, Black 5, number 5305, is now a regular performer on this line. The K1s were the last LNER design of 260, and were introduced by A.H. Peppercorn just after nationalisation in 1949, so the green livery is not authentic. 2005 was finally withdrawn from BR at the end of December 1967 as the last steam engine on the eastern region. After a long period in store, it was purchased for preservation in 1972 and was for several years based on the North York Moors Railway. Its use on the West Highland Line evokes memories of the early 50s when the class performed new on this scenic route. Glenfinnan Viaduct provides one of the finest vantage points on the line. A speed restriction of 25 miles per hour is applied over the viaduct. Once beyond, trains must climb on grades as steep as 1 in 45 to Glenfinnan Station. Climb continues beyond the station on grades of up to 1 in 50. To Malaig provides all the ingredients associated with Scottish steam. Superb scenery, steep gradients, and some of the finest locations on the network. From the Highlands to the east and south, the character of the railway system changes dramatically. Here, a network of lines links the cities of Glasgow, Edinburgh, Stirling, Perth, Dundee, and Aberdeen. Some of these lines have changed little since the days of steam. These semaphores once saw the passage of the immortal Gressley A. Forbes. Gleneagle Station remains very much as it looked in the 60s, although the signalling and sidings were removed many years ago. In the 60s, this was the point where a branch diverged away to the north, to the towns of Crieff and Comley. A4s had been transferred to Scotland from the East Coast mainline during 1963. For over 3 years, they were to enjoy an Indian summer on the tightly timed Glasgow to Aberdeen expresses. Six 0009 Union of South Africa had been allocated to Edinburgh's Haymarket shed before being transferred to Aberdeen Ferry Hill during 1963. Caprotti Standard Class 5s were allocated to Scotland and were regarded as very free-running engines. Perth, like Gleneagles, retains its grand station buildings. Today, this is still a busy junction, handling the Aberdeen to Glasgow expresses, as well as Inverness to Edinburgh traffic. Through trains to Aberdeen use the former branch platform on the line to Dundee. In 1966, the Aberdeen expresses used the former Caledonian route, diverging at Stanley Junction to the north of Perth. An A4 arrives from Aberdeen, having travelled via Forfar and Stanley Junction. Trains were handled mostly by standard classes. A Black 5 arrives on a Dundee train. An evening Aberdeen-bound train approaches the station on August the 5th, 1965. Behind 60034 Lord Farringdon. The 845 from Aberdeen to Glasgow was a regular duty for A4s and rarely ran late. Thank you. a standard Caprotti Class 5, arrives from Dundee. A Black 5 arrives from Stirling with a local bound for Dundee. A total of 9 A4s were transferred from Eastern Region to Scotland during 1963 at the instigation of Mr. J. Ness, the Scottish Region General Manager. Although primarily used on the Aberdeen to Glasgow expresses, they also worked on other duties, including various postal services. Note the B1. Acting as station pilot. Six 0026 Miles Beaver was to be withdrawn in September 1966 and was, together with Bitten, the last of the A4s to survive in service. Perth was on the major south to north route to Inverness. Traffic bound for Aberdeen had a choice of two routes, either through Perth and Forfar, or else via Dundee and the Tay Bridge. This carried a considerable amount of freight at this time. These scenes were taken from the southern end of the bridge on August the 5th, 1965. This time, this was a junction with a branch running to Tayport. Closure of the Tayport branch came 4 years after these scenes were taken, in May 1969. A regular working during the summer of 1965 was a cement train from Aberdeen to Edinburgh, normally hauled by a V2. This bridge was completed in 1885 to replace the ill-fated earlier structure which had collapsed during a fierce storm on the 28th of December 1879. With a length of almost 2 miles, this remains Britain's longest railway bridge. The largest steam shed in the Edinburgh area was at St. Margaret's. The depot had an extensive allocation. The following scenes were taken on the 5th of October 1965. The depot had an allocation of 7 B2s, late in 1965. These were used primarily on freight on the Waverley route. 60835 is preparing to work a freight over the steeply graded route to Carlisle. She was one of four V2s named after Army regiments. She carried the rather cumbersome name, the Greenhard Alexander Princess of Wales Old Yorkshire Regiment. This nameplate was probably removed to improve the engine's performance. The depot had a large allocation of B1s. Note the English Electric Type 4s. These had already displaced steam for many duties along the East Coast mainline. Buchanan Street was one of several termini serving the city of Glasgow. This was the point where the Aberdeen Expresses originated. The 1730 to Aberdeen departs. A Dundee train leaves behind the Standard 5. These scenes were taken on the 15th of June, 1966. Later during this year, on the 7th of November, 1966, this rather run-down four-platform terminus was to close. Traffic for Aberdeen left the Edinburgh line just south of Larbert. Stirling was a major stop for the Aberdeen Expresses. It was also an important junction, with branches running east to Dunfermline and west into the Highlands. At this time, a handful of Royal Scots were allocated to Carlisle, and these occasionally ran as far north as Stirling and Perth on freight. Thank you. 34 years after these scenes were taken, Stirling still retains its semaphores, while the station itself has changed relatively little. In fact, this remains the only large Scottish station to possess mechanical signalling. The route from Aberdeen to Dundee still retains much of the atmosphere of the steam age. This delightful line possesses some fine locations and several steep grades. There are two summits, one here at Carmont and another just to the south of Aberdeen. Montrose was once the centre of a number of lines. As such, it had a particularly busy yard. Many of these veteran J-37s survived as late as 1966, based at Grangemouth, Thornton, Dundee and Dunfermline. This particular example, number 64547, was based at Dundee. These were some of the last pre-grouping engines on British Railways. Pacifics were based in Scotland. Class A2 Blue Peter was transferred to Dundee in June 1961 and remained there until withdrawal late in 1966. In its last months of service, the locomotive operated mostly as a standby engine, in addition to working various reliefs. On this occasion, working a Montrose to Dundee relief. While the A4s were to spend their final years on tightly timed expresses, these powerful Pacifics were to see relatively menial duties. Ferryhill Shed was situated alongside the junction for the line to Ballaton. Late in 1965, six out of the eight remaining A4s were based here. This WD280 is a visitor, being allocated at Thornton Shed. Eight of the B2s were based at Ferryhill by the autumn of 1965. This example was to be withdrawn in August 1966. A36052, Prince Palatine, shuts down his leave after arriving on an enthusiast special. This was one